morning to all of you. I welcome all of you in the third lecture of brand management. So earlier two sessions I completed. In the first session I make you understand regarding international marketing, product, and then brand and brand management. And in my second lecture I make you understand regarding the importance of brand management, the significance of brand management, in which I explained 3 to 4 points, but this point I stretch a little bit further and I make you understand the various significance of the brand management. As we studied earlier, the brand management, it helps to increase brand awareness. This is the first benefit or significance of brand management. It helps to increase brand awareness. So as we know, the brand awareness is what? The brand awareness is the ability of customers to identify the brand. The ability of customers to identify the brand is a brand awareness. So branding, brand management helps the audience or to the customers to identify a typical or particular brand or specific brand. That is what brand awareness. The second one is, it helps to increase brand equity. It helps to increase the brand equity, that is the reputation or goodwill of the brand or name worth of the brand, the total monetary value of the brand. And third one is to increase brand loyalty. To increase the brand loyalty. So as we say, or as we know, the brand loyalty is the level of attachment of the customers towards a brand. The level of attachment of customers towards a specific brand is called as a brand loyalty. So if the brand loyalty is higher, then the brand equity will be also what? The higher. If the level of brand loyalty is lower, the brand equity level will be also lower. There is a relationship between brand loyalty and brand equity. So these three benefits the marketers get from the branding of any product or any brand. So besides this, the brand management or branding, it reduces the functional risk. Reduce the functional risk of customers. So what is the functional risk of customers? We will try to know. If as a customer I buy the product, so if I buy the product, I will be in a dilemma regarding the function of the product. Whether this product will work or not. How is this product? This quality is better or not better? Whether this will work or not. So after buying, the customer will be in a dilemma. But if the brand is strong, then the functional risk will be reduced. Because it is believed that any brand which is a strong, it has a higher quality. In that sense, the strong brands reduces functional risk. So as a customer, you need not to worry. Once you buy, if the brand is strong, then definitely the quality will be higher, the quality is better. So it reduces the functional risk of the customer. The next one is, the brand management reduces psychological risk of customer. Psychological risk of customer. So what is psychological risk? If me or you as a customer buy the product, we will be in a dilemma. Our choice is best or our choice is poor. Our choice is right or our choice is wrong. So this dilemma is called as cognitive dissonance in the minds of customers. But the brand is strong, it will reduce this cognitive dissonance of the customers, what is in their mind. That means the strong brand, it will reduce the psychological risk of the customer. The strong one is, I write here, number 6, it reduces social risk of customer. You must be knowing that once you buy the expensive products or costlier products, the luxurious products or comfortable products. I am not talking about the generic product or commodities like salt and paper. I am talking about the expensive items. Once you buy any automobile, the two-wheeler or four-wheeler, which is the costlier or which is very expensive, there is a social risk. Social risk means what you buy. Sometimes your family members, maybe your spouse, maybe your children, maybe your brothers or sisters or other family members or professional peer groups, they will not accept your purchasing decision. They will be disagreeing with your purchasing decision. Yes, you have not made the right choice. So that is a social risk. Yes, other people, whether in your family or in a society, they will be disapproving your purchase decision. This is called as a social risk. But the brand is a strong and it is a socially accepted, then definitely nobody will be disagreeing with you. The BMW, nobody will disagree that it is the ultimate machine. It's the ultimate driving machine. But this is the best one because it is proved. So that's why the societal members, they will not be disagreeing about the strong brands. So strong brands reduce social risk. Strong brand reduces social risk. Okay. I go ahead and one more significance or advantage. I would like to put here the number 7. For firm, branding or brand management helps channel advantage. It gives channel advantage. What is a channel advantage? We will try to know. If the brand is poor, the retailers or distributors, they would not like to get associated with weak brands or poor brands. If the brand is strong, the distributors, nobody dislike to have the brands like Coca-Cola and Pepsi. Everybody like, you can say, they have the association with such strong brand names because this association helps them to attract the new customers and to expand their business. So that's why the distributors and retailers enjoy association with the strong brands. And moreover, marketers will find out new ways of channels confidently when their brand is strong. How is it? Because recently the Coca-Cola, besides its traditional channel of distributions, it focused on the new way of distribution channel. That is, it contracted with many universities, institutions, organizations and companies in USA, and in this contract, what condition or what term they accepted or they made with the institutions or organizations or universities is, the universities and institutions, they have to keep the vending machine of Coca-Cola, not other brands, the soft drink brands, only the vending machine of what? The Coca-Cola. So this is new way of distribution channel. But when it is possible and the brand is strong, otherwise nobody will, you can say, entertain you to have your vending machine in their campuses. This is possible because of the strong brands. And number 8 is, besides channel advantage, the company has entry barrier. career advantage. Entry barrier advantage is, in the soft drinks there is a Pepsi, Coca-Cola and some other leading brands, but the potential entry of other newcomers is not possible because the market is saturated. The market is saturated where these established organizations only will perform, but the entry of other organizations, even though they enter, is not possible and it's very difficult for them to survive in the market. So the brand is strong, it's a cover the market, it increases the market share and it avoids entry of other potential organizations or entrance of the marketers in the market. So having a strong brands act as an entry barrier to the other potential newcomers. The next one is stock market advantage. Stock market advantage means, if your brand is strong, then definitely the prices of the shares will be higher and your organization will be considered as a valuable asset in the stock market. So having a strong brand provides marketer a strong stock market advantage. So these are what the various significances, benefits, or you can say the importances of brand management. So the next point I am discussing with you is product versus brand. In my first session, as far as the definition is concerned, we try to know what is a product and what is a brand. But this point, again in this session, I will stretch a little bit further to give some more you can say the information regarding product and a brand, and to give a new insight regarding these two aspects. As we know, what I told in my first session, product is anything that can be offered to market by a marketer. Product is anything that can be offered to market to satisfy need and wants of a customer. Anything means, I elaborated this term, anything. Anything includes, it may be a physical product like salt and paper, it may be a service like banking, insurance, institutional service or consultancy service. It includes experiences like theme parks, the Disney World. It includes shows and exhibitions, Auto Expo in India, Auto Expo in Turkey. So these are what the tremendous popular trade fair shows. So product is what? It's a shows or exhibitions. Product may be any, you can say, the product may be place or location. As I told you, the Indian tourism or India itself a country is a place. By our tourism advertisement, we invite people to visit India and to watch and observe its beautiful places, the monuments that we have, the historical monuments, and the Kerala coastline. Their tourism advertisement, you can say, promoting the place as a brand. So what I am saying, the product is a very broader concept. It includes everything. It includes physical products, surveys, events, shows, places, locations. And what is a brand? We have seen the definition also. Product, anything. Maybe a physical good. Available in the physical form, salt or paper. It's a service, banking, insurance, or consultancy. It's an experience, theme park, and then it's what? It's exhibitions. A very broader concept. On the other hand, brand. I defined in my earlier session, the previous lecture number 1, brand is a trademark, it's a name, it's a design, it's a logo, symbol, or combination of these. Symbolic aspects or symbolic components that helps to identify one seller's goods and service from competitors. So, after knowing product and brand, when we come to the conclusion, we can understand product is a very broader concept, it includes everything. The brand is a combination of these things, trademark, logo, symbol, and that helps to identify one seller's goods and service from the competitor's goods and service. Now here, the brand it becomes what? I don't have the space, I write here on this top. Brand is product plus symbolic components. Brand is equal to product plus symbolic components. Which are symbolic components? Trademark is symbolic component. Name is symbolic component. Tata, Reliance, it's a corporate name, it's a symbolic component. Trademark, their logo or slogan or any punchline or tagline they have, it's also exhibit the organization or exhibit the brand. So that's why all these things, there is symbolic component. Product in its physical form plus symbolic components is known as what? Brand. Because these symbolic components helps to identify the one product from the other products. That helps to identify one brand from the other brands. So that's why the brand is combination of product plus symbolic components. For example, Rolex, Marlboro, and Coke. These three brand names are right on the board. Rolex is a wristwatch. It's a timekeeping device. If I say the Rolex, it's only a timekeeping device, not more than that. Any wristwatch is a timekeeping device. So right here, watch. Timekeeping device. If I say Rolex, then it is what? It's a prestige. If I say this watch, simply it's a timekeeping device. If I say Rolex, it's a prestige. That means what? Any product in its physical level or physical form, simply it's what? It's a substance or a thing. But you bring it to the brand level, it becomes more than that. Rolex is a symbolic component for the prestige. The Rolex is simply a timekeeping device at the product level in a physical form. But when it comes to what? The symbolic level or brand level, it becomes a prestige or it becomes a luxury. It shows the lifestyle. And the next one is, it's an American cigarette brand, Marlboro. Marlboro is a cigarette. If simply I say cigarette, what comes to your mind? Cigarette is a cigarette, it's a plain cigarette. But Marlboro, if you see its advertisement, you may find Marlboro, a person having a rounded cap, having a stick in his hand, and then riding a horse, a particular person, Marlboro man, a smoker, rather than product itself. So Marlboro ultimately is what? It's a character, Marlboro man character, that survival against all odds. It's a fierce independence, it's a ruggedness individuality. Marlboro is a symbol of independence. It's a ruggedness, individuality. Cigarette, a product, a physical form, at the physical level or a product level, but a brand level, again it's a lifestyle. But it's a high independenceness, fear independenceness, and ruggedness, you can say. A well matured image. The person who smokes, you can say, is a very strong one. That symbolic aspect is given to the customer. So Marlboro is what? Marlboro, it stands for independence. Coke. Coke is what? Simply at the physical level or product level, it is carbonated drink. Coke is carbonated drink. But when it comes to the Coke, any carbonated drink simply is a water. Any carbonated drink simply is a water. But when it comes to the Coke, Coke is not only the carbonated drinks, but it's everything the America stands for. That is the symbol. Coke is everything America stands for. Coke is everything the America stands for. That means Coke is not only a carbonated drink, but it's everything for America, it's everything the America stands for. So these are certain examples. You understand the product only is in the physical form, but the brand is what? Product plus symbolic components. As we say, Rolex, wristwatch, a physical product. Wristwatch, any wristwatch claim, it's a timekeeping device. But brand is what? It's a prestige, symbolic component. Marlboro, a plain cigarette. But when we say the Marlboro is a symbol of